I am Mrs. Manju Sharma. Today we will start our next chapter, chapter number 5 of class 8th in history, When People Rebel. As we know that the Britishers made our country colony, and the year 1857 CE is considered to be a turning point in the Indian history. So in this chapter we shall see how the events unfolded which ignited the fire of independence and nationalism among the people, who were already feeling as if they were driven against the wall due to the oppressive and exploitative policies of British. First, we will see the uprising of 1857 revolt. Any colonial government would choose to introduce policies which are aimed to dominate. They would set out terms which would exploit and extract the maximum from the soil and the people of the occupied territories. As we saw in the previous chapters that there were simmering of discontentment, dissatisfaction, distrust and distress among the people due to the oppressive and exploitative policies of the British. Now we will see the run-up to the critical situation, then the revolt as it unfolded. What were the causes of rebellion? The rebellion of 1857 was the result of discontentment among the different sections of the society against the British oppressive policies. The causes for the rebellion of 1857 can be categorized as economic causes, political causes, social and religious causes, military causes, and immediate causes. First, economic causes. The most important cause of discontentment against the British was the policy of economic exploitation. The peasants suffered due to high revenue demands made by the company. The artisans had lost their means of livelihood. People who were working as administrative staff and workers for the kings and nobles lost their livelihood due to the displacement of the ruling classes. The company officials started draining away Indians' wealth to the England. Next, the political causes. The British displaced large number of rulers and chiefs by adopting different policies. First, the doctrine of Lepes, adopted by Lord Dalhousie, angered the ruling class. Satara, Jhansi and Sambalpur were taken away by the British on the pretext that the ruler did not leave behind a natural successor at the throne. Awadh was annexed on the ground of misgovernance. The policy of subsidiary lines took away the independence of Indian rulers. The British refused to give pensions to Nana Sahab, the adopted son of Peshwa Bajirao. It was also announced that Bahadur Shah would be last Mughal emperor and his successor would have to move out of the Red Fort. Next are the social and religious causes. The social reforms introduced by the British were looked upon with suspicion by the conservative section of the Indian society. A major cause of the outbreak of the rebellion was the fear among the people that the British government was determined to destroy the religion and convert Hindus to Christianity. Next, the policy of taxing lands belonging to temples and mosques lent fuel to fire. The social discrimination faced by the Indian due to the British attitude of racial superiority led to the large scale of resentment, and other military causes. Indian soldiers formed nearly 85% of total British troops in India. As they were an integral part of the Indian society, they too suffered the consequences of the oppressive British rule. But the immediate cause was the major cause of this rebellion. Around this time, the Enfield rifle was introduced in the army. Its cartridges were covered with a greased paper cover. This greased cover had to be beaten off before the cartridges could be loaded into the rifle. The news spread that the grease was made of cow and pig fat, as the Hindu consider the cow scarce and the Muslim do not eat the meat of the pig. Both these communities were enraged. On 10th May 1857, these rebel soldiers killed the British officers, released their imprisoned comrades and hoisted the flag of revolt. This was the official beginning of the Great Indian Uprising of 1857. Now we will see where the rebellion was spread. The main center of the rebellion were Jhansi, Kanpur, Araha and Awadh. इन झांसी रानी लक्ष्मीबाई इज कंसिडर्ड टू बी द ग्रेटेस्ट लीडर ऑफ द रिबेलियन. इन कानपुर द अपराइजिंग वॉज लेड बाय द नाना साहब द एडॉप्टेड सन ऑफ बाजीराव सेकेंड. ही वॉज सक्सेसफुल इन एक्सपेलिंग द ब्रिटिश एंड आरहा. द रिबेलियन वॉज लेड बाय द राजपूत जमींदार कुंवर सिंह इन आरहा इन बिहार. इन बरेली बखत खान लेड द रिबेलियन एट बरेली. ही कंटिन्यूड फाइटिंग टिल द डेड. अवध बेगम हजरत महल वॉज लीडिंग स्पिरिट बिहाइंड द अपराइजिंग इन अवध. शी वॉज हेल्प बाय अहमदुल्ला शाह अ मौलवी फ्रॉम फिरोजाबाद. सप्रेशन ऑफ बैलियन. नाउ वी विल सी हाउ द ब्रिटिश सप्रेस्ड द रिबेलियन. द ब्रिटिश कॉलोनियल पावर्स हैड नॉट इमेजिन्ड सच अ रिबेलियन विच वॉज स्प्रेडिंग लाइक वाइल्ड फायर इन पॉकेट्स अक्रॉस डिफरेंट पार्ट्स ऑफ इंडिया. द ब्रिटिश रथलेसली ट्राइड टू सप्रेस द रिवोल्ट. पीपल वर सब्जेक्टेड टू ऑल काइंड ऑफ क्रुएलिटीज टू प्रिवेंट दैम फ्रॉम ऑर्गेनाइज अनदर रिवोल्ट. नाउ वी विल सी वट वर द रीजन ऑफ द फेलियर ऑफ रिबेलियन ऑफ 1857. इवन दो रिवोल्ट वॉज वाइड स्प्रेड बट इट फेल्ड एंड द रीजन इट्स फेलियर वर एज फॉलोज. फर्स्ट द रिबेल लीडर्स वर फाइटिंग फॉर द रिस्टोरेशन ऑफ देयर रिस्पेक्टिव लॉस्ट प्रिविलेजेस. देयर वॉज अ लैक ऑफ नेशनल कॉन्शियसनेस. सेकेंड द मूवमेंट डिड नॉट स्प्रेड अक्रॉस द कंट्री. इट वॉज लिमिटेड फॉर सम पार्ट्स. देयर वॉज एन एबसेंस ऑफ इफेक्टिव एंड इंस्पायरिंग लीडरशिप. बहादुर शाह वॉज टू ओल्ड एंड इन पुअर हेल्थ एंड ऑल्सो लैक्ड लीडरशिप क्वालिटीज. द रिबेल्स डिड नॉट पोसेस गुड क्वालिटी वेपन्स एज कम्पेयर टू ब्रिटिश. Certain sections of the society were loyal to the British, such as Gorkha of Nepal, rendered their service to the British, the Nawab of Bhopal, and the Nawab of Hyderabad. What were the effects of rebellion? As the rule of the East India Company came to an end after the 1857, the governor was given the title of Viceroy. The policy of annexation was given up. The Queen promised not to interfere in the social and religious practices of the Indians. The army was recognized to prevent further rebellion. Jamindar and landlords were given their rights back in order to win their support and loyalty. Now we will summarize the rebellion and the nature of the rebellion. The British termed it as the spoil mutiny. British writers call it the mutiny as it was started by the soldiers after the introduction of the greased cartridge. On the other hand, the Indian call it the First World War of Independence as both Hindu and Muslims jointly took part in the revolt. Even the sannyasi and fakirs carried the messages of freedom as a secret emblem in the form of lotus or chapatis from one place to another. Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru considered it more than a mutiny, and according to him it assumed the character of a popular rebellion and the beginning of the war for Indian independence. So now we have read about the 1857, its causes, reason of failure, its centers and effect of rebellion. Goodbye, students.